the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
When upon life's billows you are tempest-tossed, when you are discouraged, thinking all is lost, count your many blessings, name them one by one, and it will surprise you what the Lord has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one.
For our Goodnight message on this Wednesday, the 10th of March, 2021, broadcasting from the Salesian Pontifical University, Rome, Italy, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to this encouraging message in line with the first reading of today, entitled, Don't Forget the Things Your Eyes Have Seen.
Does the cross seem heavy you are called to bear? Count your many blessings, every doubt will fly, and you will keep singing as the days go by. Count your blessings, name them one by one.
Today we read from Deuteronomy chapter 4 verse 1 and then 5 to 9. Moses reminding the people of Israel, the people of God, to keep the statutes. Towards the end of the passage, we hear this decree by Moses. Only take care and keep your soul diligently, lest you forget the things that your eyes have seen, and lest they depart from your heart all the days of your life. Make them known to your children and your children's children. By speaking like this, Moses knew what forgetting can do to a believer. When you forget the good things that God keeps doing in your life at a time when you are going through trouble, you get into lack of faith. When we look at the things that we are experiencing today with this COVID-19, it is very easy for us to forget how God has been faithful to us in many ways. Even when you look at what you are experiencing in your life, leave aside COVID-19, the troubles that you might be going through in your own marriage, the problems you might be facing with your own health. It's very easy to get into grumbling. It's very easy to get into complaining, murmuring, when we forget how good God has been to us all the past years of our lives. David said in Psalm 103 verse 2, "Praise the Lord, I tell myself, and never forget the good things he does for me." David told himself to never forget the good things God has done. We also must make up our minds to never forget God's goodness in our lives. As I was reading through the book of Psalms, I began to notice all the times forgetting was mentioned. We have chapter 78, chapter 103, chapter 106, and chapter 137. Psalm 107 says, "When we forget it, tests God's patience, frustrates the Holy One of Israel, and makes God's anger rise." And you know that caught my attention. At the end of going through these passages, I was convinced that forgetting God's goodness is a sin. Forgetting leads to unbelief, then rebellion. Even though the children of Israel had just witnessed the miraculous 10 plagues of Egypt and escaped 400 years of slavery, they soon forgot his many acts of kindness to them. Instead, they rebelled against him at the Red Sea. When they saw the Red Sea in front of them, behind the Egyptians pursuing them. Psalm 106 verse 7. Immediately following their Red Sea miracle, they lost hope when there was no water source, and they complained to Moses, "You brought us here to die of thirst." Repeatedly, the children of Israel forgot the miracles God had just done for them, and they grumbled, wanted to turn back, and demanded new leadership. They are not different from us. When we are faring well in life, sometimes we don't even remember to say thank you to God for what He is doing, or even to put down in writing what the Lord is doing in our lives. You know what? I have a lot to thank God for. I'm grateful to Him even for granting me this opportunity to share with you this goodnight message, because I know there are many others who are incapable of even talking because they are in a sick bed. Because I know there are many others who are in areas where they cannot even have a network to share the goodness of the Lord to others and with others. But one thing I'm grateful for, even if something happens to me in my life that would incapacitate me, I will never forget the goodness of the Lord. I want to let you know this. You are listening to this goodnight message at this moment because you have a phone, because your ears are able to hear. You are not in an intensive care unit. Forget about everything else that might be happening in your life. But remember that this is already a miracle of God, that God has given you a chance to listen. You may have sicknesses surrounding you. You may have issues around your life that may be pressing you down. But one thing, God has given you a chance to listen to this, to encourage you, to remind you that He has not given up on you. He has a lot to do with your life. And you know, He just doesn't want you to forget what He has been doing all along, because forgetting makes us do foolish things in our lives. Look at what happened to the people of Israel at Mount Sinai. The people forgot, and they got tired of waiting for Moses and traded their glorious God for a statue of a grass-eating ox. Psalm 106 verse 20. How quickly the people forgot what God had done. Forgetting causes us to get impatient and not wait for His direction. And impatient people do very terrible things. Impatient people end up going to witch doctors to seek for help, forgetting how God has been kind and merciful to them. Please, I beg you, only take care and keep your soul diligently, lest you forget the things that your eyes have seen, and lest they depart from your heart all the days of your life. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, and sweet dreams.
Same to you, Father.
Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done. So amid the conflict, whether great or small, do not be disheartened, God is over all. Count your many blessings, angels will attend. Help hope and comfort give you to your journey's end. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done.